There is a real challenge being faced by all social media marketing types, and that is diminishing and declining viral reach of our valuable content. It doesn't matter what social network we're talking about, viral reach is diminishing. And if that is the case for you, then today on the Social Media Marketing Tool Show, I would like you to meet Edgar. Steve Dotto here, contributing editor for Social Media Examiner. I'm glad you're joining us today because we are going to be talking about dealing with the issue of diminishing viral reach, especially in Facebook, but we find it across all social platforms. And content marketers face a decision point where they have to determine whether they're going to continue to invest in growing their market through viral means or if they're going to move to a pay-to-play model where they're going to actually pay to have their content put in front of their audience. Now, if you are in the camp that wants to see what you can do as far as continuing down the viral path, then Meet Edgar is a tool you should have a look at. If you drop by their website, actually, there's some really compelling statistics that help put it all into perspective. I was a little bit gobstopped when I first read this one, but the half-life of a tweet is 24 minutes and a Facebook post is 90 minutes. In other words, before your content slips below the horizon on these platforms, you have 24 to 90 minutes to reach your audience. And you recognize the fact that that's one of the big reasons that viral reach is diminishing. I mean, beyond the fact that in some cases, Facebook especially just isn't sharing your content to your entire network, we have all of these different challenges we have to address. So Meet Edgar is a tool designed to take your most valuable evergreen content and address this exact situation. How about if we dive in and have a look? Now, I have it set up, and Edgar has a unique perspective on how it looks at content. It is similar to other content publishing platforms that we use with one significant twist. It's similar in the fact that it takes our content, like tweets and posts, and it allows us to schedule them into a calendar to have them posted to our different social networks. So it works like a variety of different tools as far as that goes. What's unique is how it classifies its information. It looks at our information by category, or as people are often calling it within Meet Edgar, within buckets. In other words, you take your content and you put it into a classification with other content which is similar. And then in your publishing schedule, you don't define exactly which post you want to put forward, but rather what content you want to put forward as far as a category, as far as content from that bucket. And then it works its way through your content within these buckets and then refreshes the cycle and it keeps going. It's designed for us to take our most valuable evergreen content and create a schedule where it's continuously being published into the stream, thereby reaching a greater percentage of our audience. Let's look at some of the details of Edgar from those three perspectives, from the content, the category perspective, from the post itself perspective, and from the scheduling perspective. And let's begin by looking at the categories themselves. So these are those buckets that I was talking about where we create broad strokes within Edgar. You can see I have it set up with seven categories that I have available to me. They give you a predefined library of categories to start with, but you can edit them and create your own. Now mine are based on the type of content that I create. So I've got ones for my app review video, one for my Ask Dotto Tech videos, for my straight up blog posts where I'm just doing normal productivity videos. I've got a category for this show so I can help promote the Social Media Marketing Tools show. And I've got another category called promotional. This is where I ask for people to sign up for different opt-ins, different list builders. So you can see that my mix is giving away a lot of free content and then occasionally asking people to sign up for my mail list. Now, if I was going to, say, launch a brand new webinar coming up in a few weeks, I could create another category here that I could then increase the frequency of tweets going out about that webinar by creating a temporary category and by populating lots of tweets within that category. So you have the ability to use Edgar strategically long form, but also to use it in kind of a short burst as well. Let's have a look at how we populate those categories from the library. Now, the library is where we create and host all of our different posts. Now, the posts can be in your three main social networks. They can be in LinkedIn, Twitter, and in Facebook. So you create posts from scratch, just like you would in any other post creation tool. You can choose the category that it's going to live in, the post is going to live in. You can add the text, and then based on whether or not it's a tweet or a Facebook post, of course, you'll want to monitor how many letters you're using, etc. You can incorporate Bitly links directly within Edgar for tracking. You can incorporate and add an image, and then you can choose to have a post launch at a specific time, or you can just save it into the library, and where it's saved in the library based on which category it's in will determine when it's going to be posted into your different streams. You also have to determine which of your accounts it's going to post in. So if I was creating a tweet, I would choose the Twitter feed here, I would choose the Twitter account, and I would fill in the post accordingly. Once you've filled out your library, you will then have, in my case, I've got 43 posts all ready to go. And this I'm increasing on a regular basis. Anytime I have a new piece of content, a new video, a new blog post that deserves to be evergreen, I then create a library item for it and I incorporate it into whichever category it should be delivered in. Then all of this content is finally delivered to our scheduling tool. And if we click on the scheduling tool, we're brought into a weekly calendar, giving us from Sunday to Saturday, allowing us to determine what posts live in which time slots. Now, I use Edgar exclusively as a Twitter publishing tool, so I have a lot of posts set to go, bearing in mind that the average half-life of a tweet is about 23 minutes. My Twitter following is growing rapidly. I think this is a great way for me to reach new people, especially new people on Twitter, with my existing valuable content. Now, if I want to add a new time or modify one of the times, I can just click on that time slot, and then I can go in and I can determine exactly when and where it's posting, from which category, from which accounts. So you have the ability to basically determine exactly how this publishing process works on a weekly basis. Once you've got this established, the cool thing is Edgar will go through your bucket of content, say here for the social media marketing tool show. It will publish, if I've got 15 videos in this spot, it'll go through, you know, it'll choose number 7 this time, and then it will it'll look for the next time here it is being published again at 6 o'clock that evening. Number 8, the 8th one in the series would go, and it works its way through the entire cycle and then starts again. What it eliminates you having to do is to go in and determine which post appears at which time, which we do with most scheduling tools. It removes us from the minutia of which post it goes, and it allows us to look at it strategically as to what type of content do we want to deliver at that time. For evergreen content creators, it is a huge time saver. Now, I want to make one caveat here and make sure you understand. When we're looking at Edgar as a content publishing tool, it is not the sort of a tool that a person who's looking at a channel like Twitter as a real community engagement tool, it's not necessarily the tool for that person, because it's all about auto-publishing, which is a little bit standoffish as far as community building and engagement goes. I personally look at Twitter as a marketing and advertising platform rather than my first choice as a conversation platform. I choose to do that in YouTube comments. So if it's really important for you to engage with your community on a constant basis, you want to think long and hard about how you're going to use a tool like Edgar to make sure that your audience is still feeling the warm and fuzzies of your engagement. But if you're comfortable with being a little bit standoffish from that community and using it a little bit more as a promotional tool, then Edgar comes through in spades. Well, I hope you found this video useful and enlightening, and it's given you a new idea and perspective about how to increase your viral traffic without having to step over across and go into the paid traffic arena. Social Media Marketing Tool Show is brought to you by Social Media Marketing World. It is a gathering of the clan social media, where thousands of professionals like you and like me, people who are passionate about social media and social media marketing tools, gather together to share ideas. It's your opportunity to meet the leaders in our space, exchange ideas, and get to know each other. Social Media Marketing World San Diego. It is an awesome experience. I'll be there. Will you? Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.